The opening of the Marsha Park produced mixed reactions from MP Philip J. Pierre. While elated over the opening of the new facility, the four-time winner of the Castries East seat lamented what he referred to as the stigmatization that the Marsha community in particular has been subjected to over the years. Pierre defended the residents, stating that most of them are law-abiding citizens with the same dreams and aspirations as any other citizen and should not be placed in the same category as the small minority who choose a life of crime.
It's really with a feeling of emotion that I'm here, because I know when the government spends that kind of money in these areas, people say, why is the government spending money in Marsha? And when we spend nearly $1 million in the field, the Marsha playing field, the Marsha ground, I know many people on the radio, on the television, on the internet calling it a waste of money. A waste of money for thousands of people who can recreate and play games. A waste of money for a field that has turned out some of the best cricketers in St. Lucia's history.
Pierre recounted words of a calypso done by the Calypsonian Get Through a few years ago. The song, which named Marsha as the capital of Castries, boasted the community as one that has produced some of the most outstanding citizens in the field of sports and academics. In fact, twin brothers who hailed from the community wrote the 2015 CXC exams and reportedly received 5 grade ones between them. According to Pierre, most of the construction work done on the facility was done by community residents. The project was funded by the Taiwanese government.
It is to my knowledge that this recreational park is the very first for Marsha. I'm sure the residents are pleased to have such a useful park. It's an essential public service. It is of economic value, provides health and environmental benefits, and plays an important part in one's social life. Parks are vitally important to establishing and maintaining the quality of life in a community.
The park is equipped with a Wi-Fi system that will enable youngsters to do their homework.
We believe in equal opportunities for every single St. Lucian. And so it is no surprise that the community of Marsha is blessed with a park with Wi-Fi. When even the Prime Minister's constituency square, Beaufort South, is still struggling to put our Wi-Fi in place.
Mrs. Emmanuel referred to her government as an all-inclusive government, one that takes into account the needs of adults and children alike. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas.